Belvidere is a community that's hardworking. We're a community of 25,000 plus.
A lot of people know each other, a lot of generational families that have stayed in that community, and really a community that's always kind of depended on Chrysler as that big company to, you know, kind of give a little bit of an identity to the city.
Originally, the Chrysler plant was built in 1964 in the city of Belvidere. They've been a huge employer. At one time, they employed over 5,000 employees here. So they have been a huge part of Belvidere, not only Belvidere, the city of Belvidere, but the region.
If they close their doors, we lose the Stellantis plant here in Belvidere. It's going to devastate the community. This area is going to be a ghost town.
It's not just a plant closing, it's a community taking a hit in a variety of ways. When you look at the number of people that are losing their livelihoods there, you're not only looking at just those individuals, those, you know, several hundred thousand people, you're also looking at their children, their families, their parents, you're looking at the schools they went to, the grocery stores they frequented, the churches that they attended.
This is the largest corporation in our county. So we heavily rely on them. It heavily impacts our school district, and we all rely on the funding, not necessarily the chamber, but those tax receiving entities to make their business or organization work.
I graduated Belvidere High School, right? I've lived in Belvidere my whole childhood. If it wasn't for this facility, my parents would have never met. I wouldn't be here.
My kids grew up here. And it sure would be nice for them to be able to come back home and home be the place that they remember. Kind of breaks my heart a little bit just thinking about them not being able to come home to what they grew up with, you know? We have a 5,400,000 square foot plant out here that sits on 260 acres that has always had an investment in it, but it's not like a plant that's ancient. It's not. It's a state-of-the-art plant. And it has, over the years, continued to make, modernize itself in investment. So it is a great plant. It's a big part of our community, and we want to keep it.
We are number one in the corporation in the United States when it comes to quality delivery. Our attendance is the best in the United States. We won the J.D. Power Award back in 2020. Matter of fact, it's the only facility in Stellantis that has its own stamping plant where you can basically build that vehicle, you know, from beginning to end in one location. Whether it be Chrysler, Stellantis, FCA, whatever you want to call the corporation, they have invested hundreds of millions of dollars in this facility. This company is more than capable of building vehicles at this location to continue for decades to come.
We build the Jeep Cherokees there every day, but our vehicles, they sell. We don't have piles of vehicles sitting anywhere. Our Jeep Cherokees are on the road. They're good quality built vehicles. If the plant shuts down, it'll be total devastation, you know, like a lot of our local small businesses that, you know, we patronize, you know. All our small town businesses will suffer huge. Just not by the Belvidere plant, but also all our suppliers as well.
It's 11 o'clock right now, it's 11:08, and I've taken about 7-8 deliveries to Chrysler, and I'm already about $70-$80 into my day. And on a normal day without Chrysler, that's the whole shift. That's a 10 to 4:30 shift, and that's with the $3 an hour. So I work at the locally family owned Tom and Jerry's in Belvidere. I've been working here for about 3.5 years, and Chrysler doesn't even just create money for Tom and Jerry's, it creates jobs. I mean, when we've had layoffs before, we've had to, you know, stop people from coming in, fire a couple people. It's just, it's a big part of the community, big part of other businesses out here. Chrysler's everything. I'm scared. I mean, I'm 20 years old, I live on my own, I pay rent, car payment, I have to get a whole nother job. I don't think Belvidere will be as whole as a community without, you know, Chrysler. Everyone knows Belvidere, you know, because of Chrysler.
Here it comes.
Here it comes.
Yeah.
There you go.
All
right, you have a great day. Yeah, all these companies that are tied to Chrysler, I mean, they're gonna be losing jobs. It's hard for the community and just everyone in general. You know, I have friends who their parents have been working here for like 10, 20 years, and they have no idea what they're going to be doing after this. I think a lot of people are going to be forced to move.
We're amalgamated local union. It consists of Stellantis, the main plant, and then we have part supplier plants around. If the Stellantis plant closes, obviously the main plant will close their doors. We'll have 1,100 employees or members of ours that will basically be out without a job at the moment. That's going to affect roughly all of our supplier units. So we would have roughly approximately 500 more of our members hitting the street without a job.
You know, you have to decide. You're losing all your friends, but you're still working for a place, one of the few places that has retirements and really good benefits at the time that was happening. So it's like, you gotta hold on because you already made one decision to keep doing that.
What we've been told by the Belvidere plant is the Belvidere plant's gonna be idle. That's the information I've received. That's it. To my knowledge, that's all the information anybody's received, that the Belvidere plant's gonna be idle. There's been no documentation of any transfers or any such thing at this time.
When you get that letter, how long do you have to make the decision? And then if you accept it, how long do you have to show up to that other plant?
So contractually, they send the letters and you have 14 days to turn that back in. That usually is 14 days from the time they sent it. So you may only have a week. And then if you accept the job offer, you have 50 days from that date in order to report to the new plant.
One of the biggest concerns is probably us moving together to the same place, you know, because there's no guarantee.
We came from a closed plant, St. Louis, our plant's closed. So that information, you know what's happening and you can make educated decisions from that. Right now, all we can do is talk about every possible conceivable scenario, because I have enough points to retire. He's more than 2.5 years away.
We were just discussing last week, should we put this place up for sale now or should we wait? Right. If we wait, is there going to be an influx of everybody trying to sell? So is the market going to be flooded and we won't be able to sell? Do we sell and then all of a sudden, hey, we got product for you? We don't even know where to begin to look for a new place to live because I don't know what town I'm going to, what state I'm going to.
This is a fellow Stellantis employee's home. He hasn't been able to live in this home for just about 2 years because he had to relocate to Ohio. It was not an option to move his family out there at that time. So he's been paying his bills here and his bills in Ohio. And 2 years later, he's finally able to move his family. Another quality family leaving Illinois thanks to Stellantis. A lot of these families have had no intention on leaving this area or leaving the job even. It's a tough relocation to move out of state and coordinate everything to where you're not homeless. So a lot of families have had to be split up.
My wife and I, you know, we just recently hit the good spot of marriage, right? So it means she's been working here at the same spot for 22 years and she doesn't want to go. So that means I have to go and she has to stay here. A lot of worry, a lot of worries come along with that, like my wife's safety. If something happens to her, my parents are still alive. They live here. If something happens to them, my mom's not in good health. My father-in-law is not in good health. I'd hate for something to happen and be 300, 500 more or more miles away from home.
It's not a good feeling. You know, I came from St. Louis. It was very hurtful because I had to leave my child and my family behind because I came in February of 2009 and I wasn't gonna just take her out of school then. I went through this 3.5 years ago because they cut C-Crew and my husband had to relocate to Toledo, Ohio. I have a lot of years there. And, you know, we're down to the end now, you know, and now you have to talk about relocating again. You know, I wanna finish it here in Belvidere.
Sometimes it doesn't feel that they give two shakes about you. It just doesn't feel like they care much about about you as an individual. And how much control they have over your life is just unreal.
They value their equipment more than they value you sometimes.
Stellantis has not come out and said where they're going to put the Jeep Cherokee. The hard part with this is not having any information from the company of what their plans are. But everything that we've heard, you know, from discussions behind the scenes, their plans are to move the Cherokee down to Toluca, Mexico, and build that with the Jeep Compass that we used to build at our facility here in Belvidere. The government has kicked in plenty of money to keep product here, and they get these tax breaks and everything else. They should be keeping product here instead of sending it overseas or down to Mexico. It pisses me off.
I think the state needs to step up to do something to keep them here. They need to give them incentives. They need to work with them.
We can't do this alone. Everybody has to be pulling on the same rope in the same direction. You know, the federal government, they do have, certainly the state has a deep pocket. We don't have the wherewithal financially to be able to save this plant. But together, we will be able to do that.